grand upstanding bantam cock so brisk and stiff and spry, with a springy step and jaunty plume and a purposeful look in his eye. In his little black blinking eye he had. I took him to the coop and introduced him to my 17 wide-eyed hens. He tupped and he tupped as a hero tups, and he bowed from the waist to them all, and then he upped and he tupped them all again. And then upon the piece of me ducks and me geese, he rudely did intrude it. With glazed eyes and open mouths, they bought it all with 42, and a little bit of gratitude they did. He jumped my giggling guinea fowl and thrust his attentions upon my 20 hysterical turkeys and a visiting migrant swan. But the bantam thundered on, he did. He ravished my fantail pigeons, my lily-white columbines, and while I was looking up the butchery gar, he jumped my parrot from behind. She was sitting on my shoulder at the time. Then of a sudden, with a gasp and a gulp, he clapped his hands to his head, fell flat on his back with his toes in the air, my bantam cock lay dead, and the vulture circle of head they did. What a noble brute, what a champion cock, what a way to live and to die. I was digging him a grave to save his bones from the hungry buzzers in the sky, when the bantam opened a sly little eye. He gave me a grin and a terrible wink, the way that demons do. He said, you see them big daft buggers up there? They'll be down in a minute or two. They'll be down in a minute or two. Bantam cock, bantam cock.